The game, my wonderful viewers, we are going to be learning something very simple again and straightforward. We will not be talking much today, so it's just something little. If you notice how I started this beating that is playing at the background and there is another song on the other deck, I actually started it in a very low tempo, that means at a very low BPM, so that is beat per minute, that means the speed at which the song was moving with. So I started it with a very low speed, then I adjusted it, shifted it up to this current speed. So I will be learning how to do that today. Most of the time when you are playing at an occasion as a DJ, you have this challenge of blending two songs at the same time, playing around with the beat per minute, that is the beating of the song while it flows along. So most of the time for the normal controller, you have to use your hand to be adjusting it, but for the case of the virtual DJ, you don't have access to controlling it using your ordinary hand, that is adjusting the crossfader or the fader that is responsible, that is the slider that is responsible for adjusting this very BPM, that is the beat per minute. Look at it here, this slider here, this very one here, there's another one here for this other deck. So how do you do that in a way that it enables you to synchronize the song while you are doing it, as you are adjusting it, you are increasing it, or you are reducing it? It's very simple. The deck that is playing right now this very one is called Deck Active. This very one that is no longer playing is refers to a default deck. The reason why it is default deck now is because it is selected. If this one is not selected, it means it is not the default deck. So at this point, if I should shift the selector to this other deck, it means this very deck that is playing is the same active deck as well as the default deck. So let me shift it to the default, to make a default deck different, which is deck B is default. Now then the deck A is active. So in doing that, one of the deck is active while the other is not active. Let's see the command that is responsible for adjusting the beat per minute, that is also refers to the pitch, that means you are increasing the speed of the sound. Let's go to our settings as usual. So we'll come to our controller setting. This is it. So at this point, we have this very point. Don't worry, I will make the script available at the bottom of this video. So if you are privileged to locate that link I gave you for the downloading of my script, you can as well get it from the other side. So you can get it from the other link. There is a link in the description of this video that I provide, where if you just go in there, you have a couple of items that I put, even my scripting, that is a complete pack of the scripting. Even though I modify it from time to time, I'm going to be editing it there too, so you can go there and download it. The virtual DJ software, that is the full version, is also there with a little modification on how to go about it, the logo remover as well as others. So let's go to the main thing here. So this is the key action. If you observe, when I was playing the video, I made use of two keys. I was combining two keys together, that is this shift key together with alternate key, shift and alternate key. So the combination of these two keys, I use them to adjust my beat, that is increase the beat. If I take my hand down to control and this same alternate key, is going to be reducing it. So that is how I adjust it. You can as well use these arrow keys, but I have a reason why I'm not using these arrow keys, because I use it for other things. So it's flexible, you can put the command anywhere you want, it must not be here. So let's see the command. This is it, this is shift, then alternate key. So this is the command here. This is the first part. This one asks us, is telling us that deck active, that means the deck that is active, as I have told you earlier, pitch plus 0.000. I put a very small micro value there, so that the adjustment will be very minute, that in a way that you might not notice that I'm adjusting the pitch. It will not be noticeable until after some time you will now see that the tempo of the song is gradually flowing along with the audience. So it gives the audience to feel the vibe of the song as it is moving up gradually. You don't switch it up at once, that is brutally. So it's on a gradual process. Then I have a command, the normal command here, and, which is a normal command that you know, which is the normal and that you know in English language, is also referring to as command and. So this will have deck default, just as I've told you, that means the deck that is selected. So that means any of the deck that is active or any of the deck that is default, we automatically respond to this command. If I should put only deck active, it means if I have two deck at the moment, and one is playing and the other is not playing, it's only the one that is playing that will respond. That is if I should use this deck active alone. But in this case, I'm using deck active and deck default, which means they have two deck. You can as well, if you are the type that deal with only the two controllers alone, you can adjust this. You must not use the deck active alone and deck default. You can as well use deck A. Maybe here you change this active to A. Then this point too, you change it, this default, you change it to deck B. It will still work the same way. So that is the command. So we now have, you can, this same command is also used to pitch the song. There is sometimes when you are playing a song, you will notice that the song is not actually flowing. So you use this same command, that is this pitch micro. Let me go to my key value that does that. That this is the reason why I told you guys I'm not using these keys. So can you see, this is the reason. If you look at the keys, I just selected one of it. This is it. You can see it's giving me dot notch. So this is the same as the notch command. This notch, in the case of this notch, it's only shifted, it doesn't tamper with the tempo or the beat per minute of the song. So it only notch, that means you adjust something, just shift it, the song forward a bit or backward a bit. That is a forward and a backward. So this is it, this is left forward, this is right forward and back, sorry, forward backward, forward backward, forward. That is notch plus 10 microsecond, notch minus 10 microsecond. So the value, you use a very small micro values. So this is the command inside the notch command. This is the argument, which is the negative value. Then for the negative, it reduces it. Then for the positive, it shifts it forward, forward, backward. Then let's go to our second command here. As let's continue from where we stop. We have seen this shift plus this that does this. We now have the one that does the reverse of the action. In this case, we have a positive value here. You can see positive here, positive here. So I now use control here. Let's control alternate, the control alternate key. It's the same command. The only difference here is this value, this negative value here, you see here, which is telling us that it should reduce the tempo. So when you are using this key, it automatically reduces the tempo of the song gradually as you are pressing it continuously. Or if you press it and hold, it does it. It is a loop command. So that is how it is. So it's very simple and straightforward. I'm sure you've learned something today. Let's continue to enjoy ourselves. Thank you for being there. Thank you for continuing to enjoy yourself. Continue to learn. And let's get it going. Let me close it at this point. Don't worry, the command will be at the description of the video. Every command that I use is going to be there for you. So if you download that script that I provided in that link, that is the link I have there. That is from the upload point. You will see this. If you open the file, you will notice that this same command is applicable. You can use any value, it mustn't be the value I'm using here. So thank you very much for being there. Let's continue with our music now and continue to fire it up. So let's continue enjoying it. Let's have a feel of how it looks like so that you get to appreciate it now. Let's go there.
Okay.
Producing it right now. Can you see I've reduced it very can you see I've reduced it very well? Can you see? Let me load another track on it, then I'll be adjusting the both of them together so that you see what happens. So thank you very much. Don't forget to keep a date, like, subscribe, and get more of the details. Go through the playlist. I have so much content there. More coming your way, and I'm sure that you continue to enjoy it while I continue to give it to you as it is coming on your way.
Okay. Wow.